Heyo everybody, Haku here with my live reaction and review of 12 Beast. It is waifu time again. I usually say that for Monmusu, but I guess that kind of works for 12 Beast as well. Both by Okiano. But yeah, if you're new to these videos on the channel or whatever, if you're one of the new subscribers and you're like, whoa, this guy covers 12 Beast, I read 12 Beast. I usually combine the live reaction and review instead of doing two separate videos, because that takes much, much longer. So for this, I usually just do the live reaction, then I go back through reviewing it then and there. For some of the series that the chapters are longer or more content heavy, I really need to split it into two separate videos so I can take some time to take notes and read over the chapter a few times and see stuff I missed. But 12 Beast isn't that long. Well, it's pretty long, and sometimes it can be a bit content heavy, but not usually. And the thing is, for me to put that amount of extra time in, it's sadly, I hate to say, oh, it's not popular enough, but that's kind of it. Like, I would be putting in a lot of extra work, so I just combined the two together to make it a bit easier. So last time we had, pretty much they were going after the hunter and he hit the golem and we saw waifu-core. I guess that's what it would be, the waifu-core. But either way, let's continue on. Hunter's great attack has greatly wounded golem. However, from inside comes, previously, Ada and, they translated it as Flake? Oh my gosh. Ada and Flake met up with Arrow and learned about the danger facing the werewolves. They headed towards the werewolf's location in the golem snowmobile, but the golem's exoskeleton was destroyed by hunter sniping while underway. And now we get a better look at waifu-core on this little cover page. I like her little, like, and her, like, round-ended feet. Everybody just looking at her. Yeah, and I called it too when they called the golem a her. I was like, hold on, Golem's about to be a waifu, isn't she? I thought Golem was a guy up until that point. Sorry, I'm just taking in this art. Flake's reaction. Okay, now we can continue on. Golem, you're Golem, right? It got turned into a girl, says Ada. It shrunk, says Arrow. Affirmative. However, Golem is the categorical term for automatons which transform magic energy into kinetic energy. Therefore, it is unsuitable as the name of an individual such as myself. If you wish to refer to me as an individual, please use my serial number. That is Theta 10038. Theta? What's that? Says Arrow. Theta, is this fine? I mean, well, it doesn't really seem like you're stronger than before. Do not worry. It is true my body is smaller than before. However, in addition to decreasing my volume and increasing my mobility, thus they worded this in bad grammar, but I get what they mean. It also decreases my chance of getting shot again because it increases the mobility. This form requires far less magic energy for movement. The extra magic energy allows for an increase in my other abilities. Oh, if that's so. I don't quite understand it, though, thinks Arrow. Well then. We're evacuating, she says, running off. Eh? And then they see the glint of Hunter's beam and it fires towards them again. They all dodge out of the way. Why the fuck didn't you... Did you run? Didn't your abilities increase, Flake? Affirmative. My abilities did increase. However, I did not possess abilities that could rival those of a Gigas. But that's strange, says Ada. If we're getting shot at, that means the enemy can see us, so conversely, we should also be able to see him. Arrow, were you not able to see the Gigas with your falcon eye? That's completely... You'd think there's no way you could miss something as big as a Gigas, but... And then, she starts to see, you can, he had active camo. We see that parts of the Gigas, at least, are translucent, I would suppose. They're not completely transparent. And it becomes more transparent. It can activate camouflage. What's that? It's turning invisible. To think he could also manipulate light like this. It's bending light to conceal itself. He'll have no way of seeing where he's going to shoot us from. Oi, then let's get out quick and get away from here. No, moving now would be bad. Okay, sorry, that was difficult to read a bit. Very small page for whatever reason. If we can't see the enemy, there's no point in hiding. Besides, I'm curious about why he isn't shooting that laser more frequently. Huh? He doesn't need to accumulate energy between shots. That could be it, but it's probably related to the steam. Steam? Lasers decay relatively quickly in the atmosphere. Smoke and steam in particular dissipate the beam, almost completely negating it. Of course. Besides, this is covered in ice. The more he shoots, because of the laser's heat, the more steam fills the air, so you can't shoot recklessly. So staying inside the steam should be the safest option for now. Smart, because of course the beam would get scattered by random particles in the air. And it's sort of as well... It's making me think that maybe it relies, because we see the light above them, and it's saying that maybe he has to charge up or accumulate energy. Maybe he does have to accumulate light in a way, because I thought before he said his powers were based on light or something, and we know that that could be true of the 12 generals overall, because Indra required water to be able to fire its beam, and that's why it had the intake valves to pressurize it, or to draw it in so it could be pressurized. How do you know so much about lasers? That's foo-foo-foo. Don't you know, Flake-san? That in the surface world, laser weapons are quite common, says Arrow. Really? Says Flake. It's somewhat of a military secret, but apparently it's already a well-known fact. Is that for real? The surface is scary. I saw it in a manga. I can't say it. I can't bring myself to tell her it's just a fictional game setting. However, the steam will soon disperse, and when that happens, the enemy will fire again, says Golem. We can't just wait here forever. But we can't do anything about not being able to see the enemy, says Ada. But if I watch from the skies, I might be able to figure something out, like the shape of the trees or the dust raised by the Gigas. If I'm able to watch the enemy from outside of his range of fire, I might be able to roughly grasp his location, says Aero. What are you saying? There's no way you can fly here. I mean, as soon as you left the steam wall, you'd get shot down. Thought so. While watching out for the enemy, there's no way I'd be able to get out of his range immediately. There is a way, says Golem. Alright, and now we see the Gigas. What was his name? Vajra? Vajra moving through the snow. And the hunter is at the helm. That's not steam. Maybe smoke. What the hell are they? And then we see they lit a fire inside of a tire, and they're running with it. Thank God you have solid fuel like a rocket. Flake, it really helped out. Shut up. If I knew we'd set up a smoke screen while running around, I wouldn't have come, she says. It's fine. Hurry up. There's another beam coming. A smoke screen? That's troublesome. I can't use these magic goggles from inside the Gigas, after all. I can't snipe like that. However... He just recklessly fires the blast into the smoke. Ada-san, Flake-san, says Arrow. I don't like shooting sloppily like that, but anyway, their running stopped. If I don't something the idle ones out. Pick the idle ones out? That's what it seems like. Weird. And are those scarecrows of the two of them? A dummy. That was dangerous, to think he'd shoot indiscriminately like that. The forest disappeared. I'm never fucking doing this again. Now, Arrow, now. Is this really safe? Will this really lift me to the sky in one go? And she's sitting on top of Golem's hand. In the first place, how do you plan on lifting me? Do not worry. Physically, there is no problem with this plan. Physically, does that mean there are problems in other aspects? Affirmative. However, there is no time left. Therefore, I'm launching. You said affirmative. Wait, launching? And she just fires her hand into the sky with a arrow still on it. We see Vajra starts aiming up. Kuh. I thought I was gonna die. And then she takes out the cell phone. Ada-san, can you hear me? Arrow, are you okay? Yes, somehow. Though I'll never do that again. Alright, now descend just a bit until you can see the Gigas, then keep an eye on him, please. The Gigas should still be near his last firing location. What? Can you talk with Arrow through this? Flake says, grabbing the headset. Ada-san, can you hear me? It's making a weird B sound. That's because it's a wireless headset, he says. Well, to be precise, it's software for a game machine that allows it to make phone calls with a smartphone, but I have no idea how it's working in this world. Why are radio signals even reaching here? Do you also want to talk with Arrow, Flake? Not really. Over there, the place without trees and a fan shape. That's where the beam came from. Found it. You can't see it, but it's over there. Ada-san, I found the Gigas. It's at your 10 o'clock. All right. If I at least know where it is, I can do something about it. If the opponent is a Gigas, there's nothing we can do but combine. Let's go, Arrow. Let's combine and shorten the distance in one go. All right. That's right. She's not here. She's monitoring him, and the enemy is watching, so she can't come back. That means... And he looks over at Flake. Bah, fuck off. Don't do that. I won't do that combined thing. No, but even if I say combine, you'll soon return back to original. Get away. That's not what it is, he says, trying to go towards Flake. I saw you combining at the fish people village, so I know. You call it combining. Breasts, she says. Is that... But you're only fondling breasts. Even if you say that, if we combine, we might be able to counterattack, you know? Hurry up, let's do it before the steam clears and he shoots us again. Shut up, get the fuck away, pervert! And Flake is still trying to get away. What the hell, even though you told me to touch your tits back at the cave? That was... Arrow was just hearing all of this through the cell phone. Even if you touch my breast unwillingly, it was fine, but... it's not, but combining, Well, will he even understand what I'm thinking? If that happens, won't he find out I'm just a loner? Oh, she's afraid that he'll find out her actual nature. Well, what should I do? That's not an enemy we can fight without combining. Flake is just one of my favorite characters ever. I love her little monologues to herself. We also can't run away. Then, that Golem, if he can combine with her... Ah, fuck, I can't find her through all the smoke and steam. We'll end up shot while searching. Flake, are you... perhaps worried that I'll find out that you're a loner? And she screams. The fuck? How do you know? I mean, do you have any fucking proof that I'm a loner, cunt? I freaking love the way that Flake speaks. When we were speaking our minds at the cave, I had a vague feeling about it. Then fucking how? I understand, he says, crying. Ever since I was a kid, my grandpa, he'd take me around for shinobi training and survival. And then we see some flashbacks. I hardly ever went to school, so when I finally became a middle schooler, I was finally able to stay in school most of the time, but... I'm Toga Ada, he says, just slowly muttering. I hope to get along. Ada, first year middle school. I didn't know how to socialize with people. Besides, because of my training with Grandpa, I was covered in wounds from head to toe, and everyone was overly wary of me. Until I got into high school and made some loner friends. I was alone throughout the whole 3 years of middle school. That earned me the name Lone Wolf. Flake starts to tear up, too. That's why, after talking to you in the cave, I thought Flake was suffering the same hardships I did. That's enough. That's fine already. I get it. Everything. You're my comrade, Flake. The way that they're just so dramatic together. I guess that's fate. If you say you were like that, there's no reason for me to deny. You mean, grab him. my breasts, let's combine. Is that fine, Flake? Werewolves don't go back on what they say. Test them as much as you want. It's really fine, right? I'm touching them, I'm going to touch them, so... Wait, if you say it so formally like that, I'm going to touch them, I won't stop anymore. Hey, wait, that's... Wait! The steam finally cleared out. Really, this laser is really inconvenient. I mean, any laser weapon, technically, scientifically, is pretty inconvenient. Oh, are they finally going to combine? Found them. Well, then let's finish them. I hope it's a cool form like the a stereo form was. That was probably my favorite one so far. And then he sees him Groper. Oh my gosh. Anyway, combination complete. A new gauntlet form witnesses power. Now it's our turn to hunt. And it looks like a giant claw with a big scarf coming out of it. I'm curious as to what its power will be. Because really, the power of the arrow form gauntlets, whatever, but the power of the a stereo form gauntlet was really badass to be able to meld metal into whatever shape you wanted. And I think that's probably going to be the end. It looks like the next one is going to be out on April 9th? Or no? Yeah. Yeah, I can't tell if that says April 9th or the 4th of September, but I'm assuming it's April 9th, because I'm pretty sure that first kanji is the one for the month. So yeah, early next, depending on how long the translation takes, we probably only have a couple weeks, maybe a month until the next one. But that all depends on translation, as I said. That was really good. That was funny, through most of it. And you guys know I really love Flake, so any big focus on her, I'm going to think is funny. So, yeah, let's just scroll back through this and discuss it a little bit. It actually took me a while just to read that one, so it was pretty heavy on content. Also, just seeing from this first page again, I like Golem's eyes. I like Golem's design in general. Still not waifu, though, because Flake is best girl. You can't... Flake is probably one of my favorite manga characters at this point, so, I mean, you can't just beat Flake. And also, she has the chin thing. I'm not sure how I feel about that. But the things under her eyes are pretty cute. I like the way that Golem speaks as well. Okay, just moving through. Trying to guess. When she just said, we're evacuating, and starts randomly running. The art as well for the first cover was really good, and the art for when, just in general, the almost transparent Vajra looks cool, the way it's only slightly distorted, and I think Okiyato did a good job with how he portrayed it in the art style. I like the way it's just not instantly invisible or visible, it has this sort of blotchiness to it when it's slowly transforming from visible to invisible. Also interesting to note that the hunter can't actually use the goggles while he's in it, which he gets the laser, he gets the invisibility, but he also loses the ability to snipe and use the goggles that can see through stuff. And like I said too, I know he uses laser, which is a light beam really, as his weapon, but I think more than that, I think most of the technology that hunter uses is based on light. Similar to the way the fishermen had stuff that was based on water. Just still moving through, seeing if there's anything more to discuss. The plan as well to just fire arrow up into the sky ended up being funny. I like some more of this, just the random panels. Like, the art is always really, really solid for 12 Beast. Even the backgrounds with the trees and everything... just got to that page again with the dummies of Flake and Ada. I like this panel as well. There's pretty much no real background, but that's because they're in the mist. But this one panel with Arrow and Golem was funny. Moving along, she fires her into the sky. Like I said, it was a really good one for comedy. I was laughing through most of it. Weird bringing up, they're either I'm not sure if Okiato's lampshading the issue, where he's like, you know, how does the cell phone even work? There are no, like, cell towers or satellites for the signal to bounce off of or anything. I don't know if he's, like, lampshading it, just bringing up that it doesn't make sense in order to make a joke of it, or if it's actually seriously something that's going to be addressed and brought up later, and if there's actually some more real logic behind that somewhere in the series. Then he decides to combine, and we are going to combine with Best Girl. Very many lewd panels. I love the way they get all, whenever they talk, like when they talked in the cave, how they like exaggerate everything when they're together and everything. It was really funny. And just, like I said, I love Flake as a character, one of my favorite manga characters. We're seeing a little bit more of Ada's backstory as well. Okay. I'm not sure how I feel about them changing the translation from Flake to Freki. Just really not sure how I feel about that. I feel like Flake is easier because I feel like it's... I don't know. I feel like it's what Okiyato was aiming for, probably, especially since she comes from the snowy village. They probably... That's why he decided to go with Flake as her name. And then we have the transformation at the end. I will admit I don't think it looks as cool as the Asterio form for the gauntlet, but it does look cool. And I think it could be cooler if we see what sort of power it has. So yeah, once again, thank you for the translation, Heart and Feather Translations, and that would be it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and this chapter, of course, so like if you did like the video, and I guess comment down there to... Tell me, also I should say, I usually don't give a score for 12 Beast chapters. I mean, I would have to think a lot more to put a score to something. I don't think it would be fair to just, rashly jump in there with one. Comment down there, tell me what you thought of this chapter, what you thought of my thoughts on it. Subscribe for more 12 Beasts and a bunch more on the channel. Like I said, sometime in April, mid-April, maybe we should be getting the next one, depending on how long the translations are going to take. Also, I suppose, follow on Twitter if you want. We'll try to keep you updated there on stuff for the channel. That is it. Thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.